Hey, hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. We are in the super secret level 8. Well, it's not secret if you play through the game. You are in a Gradius-style side-scroller thingy, as you can see here. Don't worry about touching the sides. You can touch the sides if you want to. One button shoots little stars like this. The two button lets you charge with your Landia. Needless to say, Landia was not the real enemy here. It was Maglor all along! Freaking betraying friends or something. Tyler, that's... Never mind. Let's just beat this level and beat this game once and for all. Well, you know what, we still got those special item ability stages and whatnot to complete later on. I'm just trying to be dramatic, sort of, even though I'm not really good at being dramatic. I'm more of the random type of person. And as you see these enemies right here, they really, really remind me of, like, those Sphere Doomers. Maybe they're like Sphere Doomers' cousins or something like that. I mean, just look at their body mass, their shape, their facial expression. Yeah, it just gives me off a Sphere Doomer impression. Not that it's a bad thing. I mean, I like the Sphere Doomers. And these things, I don't think you can destroy. But you can charge through them, but you can't really destroy them. I at least I don't think you can, unless I'm just not shooting them fast enough or shooting them enough. I don't know, I just dodge those starry thingies there altogether and just not worry about them. Hitting the switches opens up the walls, should be pretty obvious. It's like space and everything in Kirby's world is controlled by those switches. I just don't know how it works. Maybe it's like remote control electronic. I have no idea. I probably shouldn't question that then. Oh dang it, I missed that cherry. Well, I guess I don't really need the cherry considering that I'm doing pretty well anyway. So yeah. But if you want that cherry, don't hit the switch before you get the cherry. You have plenty of time to get that cherry too. Look out here or you'll get squished. Try and wedge yourself into places that you know are safe. Look ahead, plan ahead, and you should be fine. See, these just don't have any effect whatsoever. You know, my bullets. You can get a lot of food because a boss is here. Well, you know, get a lot of food before the boss. By the way, the song is awesome. That is all. Uh-oh, it's Maglor. With the Lore Star Cutter. Oh yeah, the ship we restored, we now have to destroy. And this is pretty much why the Landia had to defeat Maglor earlier, because of the fact that they knew Maglor was evil, and, you know, Maglor told us that Landia was evil, but in turn, you know, he was just tricking us into defeating Landia, but really Landia is the good critter of this game. Oh my god, not the ores, anything but the ores. You have to kind of like alternate between them and move up and down as you're shooting if you don't want to. Oh shoot, 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 I didn't mean to get caught in there. I want to, ow. I want to get out. I got a little bit too close there, trying to get some more shots off there. I got greedy. That was my own fault. I should have just went behind it. I would have been safe. And at the halfway point, it's going to get a lot more aggressive. Grab the food so you can recover some life if you can. And that was terrible dodging on my part. These red ones home in on you. Just thought I would mention that. You can't shoot through the shield, so don't even bother. It's going to try charging towards you. Dodge that. Now it's going to shoot from behind you. Just dodge. Not all that hard to dodge. It's just a wave pattern of sorts. The further you are away from the ship, the easier it is to dodge that because of the fact that you'll have more time to react and the spacing will be a lot bigger. And this one always goes around clockwise. So whenever you see it starting to charge up that attack right there, just go underneath it and whoa! So I guess that's what those things were used for behind there. Not just stabilizers, they're used for genuine attacks. This ship is one dangerous ship. Unfortunately, we have to destroy it. We could use the ship for ourselves, but no, we must destroy it because it is not under our control. That ship is quite a powerful ship, actually. It's like, almost like Kablua in a way. It's like imitation Kablua flavoring. You should know Kablua from the Kirby series anyway. It appeared in a couple of games. Most recently was Superstar Ultra. Super Ability Power-Up Music, by the way. Yeah, go Maiden Knight! Oh dear. No! Poor Landia. Alright, here we go. Here's the real final boss of the game. And it dares to give you the Spark Power-Up, which pretty much breaks the entire boss. It really is this boss's weakness of all the powers that they have there. It even deflects its shots that it goes after you with. You look sinister now, but you don't stand a chance against my spark. Alright, this is Magalore, the actual fight between you and him. Look at that, it just deflects his shots. When you have a shield up, of course. You're a very bad aim there. I mean, that was really, really bad. You notice that those goo puddles appeared on the floor. That's where those spikes are going to appear from. You can dodge them either by moving in between them or just by floating at the top of the screen. And after at half point there, he'll of course charge up. And I believe you want to run from this because it's like a black hole of sorts. People compare Megalore to Marx in a way from Superstar. That's that and another kind of attack which he'll most likely do is a very similar thing that Marx does, but otherwise he doesn't really remind me too much of Marx. This is the other attack I was referring to, so that black hole and this Kamehameha move here is the only thing that really does. Otherwise everything feels pretty unique to me. Oh god. No, I must get... Yeah! Cannot lose that power, otherwise I'm probably screwed. And now he's gonna turn super, and of course that means you're gonna need a super ability. Excuse me. He's gonna give us some enemies. This is what I'm looking for. Oh, little snaky snake, gonna get burned so quickly. Poor thing, as well as Magalore himself. I kind of feel sorry for him, you know, having to face up against these super powered abilities. First, he had to deal with Spark. And now he has to deal with Monster Flame. He can knock out your ability, which is probably something he should be able to do. I mean, he should have done from the start, which would have made a whole lot of sense, you know, in terms of baddie-wise. You know, why would you allow someone to be able to attack you anyway? It doesn't make much sense. Anyway, just need to do it one more time. No, I'll just skip that. Black hole. Yep. Just run away from it. It's kind of like Wispy Woods' inhale attack. And let's go for it. And I missed. And I missed again. Come on, do something. Well, not that. I mean, you know, get in the way of my flare beam. And now he's going to knock your power out again. Boop. That's okay. We're going to get another one. Soon. Come on, which one is it? It is the one over... No, not that. There we go. What? I don't want to suck... It's because he started deforming those balls as I was sucking him... sucking the enemies in with the sword. I mean, while I was sucking in the sword enemy power, I just kept sucking. You know, it's the game's auto-detection of that, so to speak. And now, with that sliver of health left, don't let him recover! Rape him! Shake the Wii Remote! And that's how it's done. And now the game is finished. Well, at least the main game. Or is it? Yeah, there's one last form. oh boy. And he's going to knock your power out immediately. But don't worry, he'll give you some stuff to work with right away. These enemies right here. Uh-oh. I see that first one. Gimme. Yeah! And once again, he is very weak against the spark power-up, as it deflects all of his energy attacks. Not these things, though. You can just duck in the center or go in the corners to dodge that, no problem whatsoever. Very easy attack to dodge, just as long as you pay attention to where those stars are pointing. And he'll also use those portals to shoot out energy beams, which is probably one of his coolest attacks as well. And also use them to teleport himself to charge into you, like so. And he's gonna go across the bottom, like that. No problem to dodge, just pay attention to the portals, as I said. And I'm way too close to him. Look out for Kamehameha. God, that attack looks cool. And I missed with my spark, dang it. That makes me very sad. And somehow I missed again. Maybe it's because he had the invincibility frames from me nicking him with my spark power. I'm just going to use his shield right now. This is a pretty easy boss with the spark. Oh, this square represents, well, rectangle represents the screen size. So dodge where there isn't a pattern. And there you go, no problem whatsoever. Charge up spark. Deflect all those suckers. It just breaks this boss. It's like no other boss before it. Now, pay attention to his arms. Whichever arm he moves forward first is the arm that he's going to be swinging. So, like that, and I'll go to the other side. Feel free to attack him if you'd like as well. Aw, he went in the background. That makes me sad. And I keep mistiming my spark shots as he's teleporting. That's okay. As long as I have my good old shield, he can't really touch me all that much. What you gonna do? What you gonna do? Oh my. Oh yeah, that's right. He does that wherever his arms are pointed, and wherever his body is pointed, excuse me. That's his indication as to where those things are going. And he's almost dead, so you really don't have to worry about him too much longer. Avoid that Gordo. You obviously can't suck that in. Or defeat it with even the spark. Oh god, pyramid. Dang you and your pyramid schemes. You almost got me there. You can't touch the floor when you got that. I mean, doing that attack. And that is all. And that is why you should choose the spark power up. The crown is gone. And Magalore goes the way of the dodo. Looks like the dimension is breaking apart. This doesn't seem very safe. Oh boy. Save us! Landia made it! As did the lore somehow. I mean, Landia pretty much desecrated the lore before. Or decimated, excuse me. So, don't know how it's flying now, but whatever. We're saved! Everything is good! We do get to use the ship after all. Well, kind of. I'd prefer to ride my dragon friends, obviously. Well, at least they would. That ship is a pretty cool ship, I have to say. Remember Magalore said that ship had a mind of its own? There you go. It's able to sail itself through space, as well as, well, save you. No, Kirby! Wake up! Get the smelling salts! Or a butterfly, that'll work too. We lived! Oh, poor King DDD. He is always the comic relief. Gotta love how they synced up the Landias to the music there. No, the ship is gone! But it doesn't matter, I guess. The day was saved. Thanks to the Powerpuff Girls. And that is the actual game's ending. This is the credits. As I said, this game is awesome! That as soon as I played this game my first time, I absolutely had to make a walkthrough on it. I just could not resist. It was just too awesome. And that's really all I have to say. Of course, there's more to, you know, this game, because there's those other stages that I haven't completed yet, as well as the mini-games, which I'll be doing a little bit later. But yeah, that's it for 100%ing the game in a nutshell. Otherwise, everything else is inside the lore. And I guess Rainbow Dash is making those rainbows in the background, because there's no way rainbows could ever be like that normally. Never mind. You're not going to get that joke unless you know something else. You know, I got a little slideshow going on here with the credits of our travels in the past, the enemies we've faced. Maiden Knight wasn't really there most of the time. Well, he would have been if I played this multiplayer, excuse me, but I always do things on my own. It's sort of a personal challenge of sorts that I like doing with games, even if there is multiplayer, because it's just dang fun to say, hey, yeah, I managed to do everything on my own. Because it's like saying, you know, you completed all the challenges that the game set for you, you were able to overcome everything on your excuse me, by yourself, and that's a pretty good feeling to say. Well, I guess you can't really say a feeling. Well, you could say a feeling. You could describe a feeling as such. You get what I'm saying. Ah, Nutty Noon. The place when I had the quiet time. I think that was the boss rush area there in that picture. The last stage in Nutty Noon. Yeah, because it's right before the Grand Doomer. Awesome freaking boss fight right there. Magalore is a pretty fun boss fight as well. And, well, as long as I'm talking about things randomly, yeah, I love the music of the Magalore fight as well. Can't help but say that. After you beat the game, you also unlock a new mode called the Arena, and you also unlock the game's sound test as well, so you can also go through those if you want for the fun of it. I'll probably go through the Arena, and something else that I haven't really gotten to yet, even playing this game on my own, is beating the EX mode, or the extra mode, whatever you want to call it. It is something that unlocks after beating the game as well. It is basically just a harder version of the original game that you just seen me play through. I don't really see much difference in like where things are hidden. Everything seems to be hidden and collected in the exact same way. It's just that they throw more enemies at you. You have half the health. You take double damage. And that's pretty much it. So it's not, I mean, it is harder, don't get me wrong, but it's not like I would have to cover that in a walkthrough, so I'm not sure if I would want to record the EX mode of this game. Just saying. Just thought I would explain that for you if you don't see any EX mode parts pop up. Maybe I'll like show a tad of it as a demo in a later part or something like that, I don't know. There's the Lore Star Cutter and the four Landias. And the end of the credits. Remember, I didn't make this game. These people all did. I just made the walkthrough on it. Buy this game. I highly recommend it. Clearly, it's not goodbye. There is a question mark at the end of that end. Because... there it is. The extra mode. And there's the arena. And there's the sound test. All as promised. The theater opens up after you see your first cutscene, so it's basically whenever you start the game, like, immediately. So that's pretty easy to unlock. Ninja Dojo was 15 energy spheres, Scope Shot was 30, as shown by the, or I should say, on the inside of the lore Star Cutter. Delete file. You don't want to do that. Unless you want to do that, you know, restart the game from the beginning or something like that. But anyway, that's all I'm going to be doing in this part. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next part when we do some more poop. I don't know what I'm doing first, though. I'll have to plan some stuff out. Anyway, doo-doo!